Hi everyone and welcome. In this video, I want to talk to you about the git clone function, which is used to essentially, you can say, download a repository in your local system. So first of all, navigate to your GitHub profile or any GitHub project that you would like to clone. I'm just going to select one of mine, which is kind of small, you can say. So let's go with this one. It doesn't have that many files. And then you need to click on code and then select either SSH or HTTPS. So for SSH, you need to have the SSH and GPG keys added to your GitHub profile. If you want to use this method, which is, you can say, considered to be relatively more secure, you would need to set up the SSH keys. In case you do not have them already set up, you should see the link on the top right to be able to do that and then come back. Or in the second scenario, you can simply just use the HTTPS method. So I'm just going to copy this and then move to my desktop. And over here, I'm going to create a new folder. I've named it test repository. I'm going to go into that and then right click and select git bash here. So now that I'm here, I can now run the git clone command followed by the URL of the repository that I had and then hit enter. And as you can see over here, the repository got cloned. However, if you noticed, it created a new folder within my test repository. So in case I wanted that within the test repository, I should have these two files. What I could do is simply add a dot at the end of this command. And just to quickly show you that, I'm going to create a new folder over here and call it test2. And then move into that and right click and repeat the same process, git bash here, and then run the git clone command. Now at the end, I'm going to add a dot and then hit enter. So now, as you can see, instead of creating a new folder, I have the source files directly within my desired folder. So that is all that I wanted to share. I do have the SSH keys added to my account. So if I were to use this link, it would succeed as well for me. As you can see, the repository cloning was successful even with the SSH link in my case. So hope that this video helped. In case you have any questions, please drop them down in the comment section. And if you like the video, give it a thumbs up and do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you all for watching and have a nice day.